بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، أبو هريرة narrated that the Prophet عليه السلام said that the strong believer is better and more beloved to Allah than the weak believer, while there is good in both. And from the names of Allah is Al-Qawi, or the strong and the powerful. And Allah said about Himself, indeed Allah is the provider, the possessor of power, the strong. And Allah also described Jibreel alayhi salam in the Quran when He said, indeed the Quran is a word conveyed by a noble messenger, a possessor of strength, with the owner of the secure throne, obeyed in the heavens, and trustworthy. All of this meaning that Jibreel alayhi salam was a strong and powerful creation. And Ibn Kathir said in his explanation of the Quran that from the strength of Jibreel alayhi salam is that he destroyed the towns of the people of Lut using only the tip of his wing. And in the hadith we mentioned in the beginning of the strong believer, it doesn't mean to just have a strong body, to have lots of muscles, to be a bodybuilder, to show off at the gym. But it means to be strong in the obedience of Allah, to be strong in the worship of Allah. The strong and the healthy and the fit believer is able to stand for prayer longer at night, and is able to fast more, is able to strive in the path of Allah, and help the weak, and help the needy. And along with a strong and healthy body comes self-determination. In order for us to worship Allah to a higher level, we need to be self-determined. We need to have the strength of our nafs, or the strength from within, psychological strength. And the persistence to establish truth and to eliminate falsehood, to enjoy what is good and to forbid what is evil, and to be patient upon doing so. Because indeed, this is one of the hardest of tasks one can do. And Allah described Prophet Dawood by saying, and remember our servant Dawood, the possessor of strength. Indeed, he was one who repeatedly turned to Allah in repentance and to seek guidance. And the Prophet said that the most beloved fasting to Allah was the fasting of Dawood. He used to fast on alternate days, meaning he used to fast for one day and break his fast the next day. And the most beloved prayer to Allah was the prayer of Prophet Dawood alayhi salam, who used to sleep for the first half of the night and pray for one third of the night and again sleep for one sixth of the night. And in many places throughout the Quran, Allah gives importance to the gathering of both strengths, like the strength of the physical strength and the spiritual strength, or the strength of one's faith. And in the description of Musa alayhi salam in the Quran, Allah said, one of the women said, oh my father, hire him. For indeed the best one you can hire is the strong and the trustworthy. I.e. being strong physically and spiritually. And in the explanation of this ayah, the scholars mentioned that there was a large rock on top of a well that could not be moved except by 10 men. However, Musa alayhi salam was able to move this rock by himself, and he was also the strongest in lowering his gaze. I mean, he wouldn't look at women, who Allah forbade him from looking at him. He wouldn't look at worldly desires. He wouldn't look at those who are higher in rank than him, and higher in worldly rank than him. And he wouldn't look into other people's businesses or other people's houses. He would mind his own business, and he would lower his gaze, and he would worship Allah. We can see that from many of these evidences that we mentioned in this translation, that it is highly recommended for one to maintain a strong level of fitness, or to be as strong as possible as we can, physically and spiritually and mentally. All of this in order to worship Allah in a better manner. And more importantly than being physically strong is to be psychologically and spiritually strong. Due to the great need of Islamic knowledge in the time that we live in. If one is not physically strong, this is okay, but if they're lacking in knowledge, if the society lacks in knowledge, then the society is more prone to going astray from the path of the Sunnah due to lack of knowledge. And Allah is not one for one who has become strong, who has become physically strong, or even psychologically strong to use this strength to show off and to walk around proudly on the earth. Allah says, have they not traveled through the earth and observed how was the end of those before him? The end of those before them. They were greater than them in power, and they plowed the earth and built it up more than they had built it up. And their messengers came to them with the clear evidences. And Allah would not have ever wronged them, but they were wronging themselves. And Allah also said regarding to the people of Ad, He said, as for Ad, they were arrogant upon the earth, without the right to be as such, and they said, who is greater than us in strength? Did they not consider that Allah, who created them, was greater than them in strength? But they were rejecting the signs of Allah. So we sent upon them a screaming wind during days of misfortune, to make them taste the punishment of disgrace in the worldly life, but the punishment of the hereafter is more disgracing, and they will not be helped. Brothers and sisters, in the time we're living in, alhamdulillah, the leaders of this country have made it very easy for one to exercise, be fit. We can see that in most neighborhoods, there would be a park, there would be a running track, there would be places where we can perform physical activities. And all of this comes back to our decision. We decide the way we eat. We decide the things we do in our free time. Either we use our time to exercise and to be strong and to seek knowledge, or we waste that time. And these decisions all come back to us. And we ask Allah to make us those who make the best of decisions. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, Muhammad Ali, and Sahbihi, and Jama'i.